you know, I was just at a Television Academy event that was the Hall of Fame, and they honored Diane Carroll. And you think about how many doors that she opened. I can't even begin to talk about how many people open doors that I benefited from.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to another uniquely inspired edition of FOSDP. We are live here in Beverly Hills, California. How important is it for you to reinvent so that you continue to provide the world with creative material?
That's interesting. I think when you stop reinventing yourself, that you're creatively dead. For me, as a director, I think the day that I'm not nervous about shooting something or how it's going to cut together or if it's really going to be genuine and believable and flow, I think the day when I'm overly confident and I feel that, oh, I got it in a bag, is the day that I phone it in and I'm no longer exciting and I don't need to do it anymore. I think as a creative person, you are always looking to create more. I mean, that's the word. It's create. It's not duplicate. So we are creative, and therefore we continue to build upon what we've already set forth.
You're very successful. You've been able to have great opportunity. How important is it for young people to have a mentor? Did you have any mentors?
Absolutely. I had a fabulous mentor. I have several. The biggest one is Paris Barkley, who's an episodic director who's won two Emmys. And he was really instrumental in breaking me in from being a music video director into an episodic director. He mentored me. He allowed me to shadow and observe him on sets. He introduced me to a whole bunch of people. When I first started getting episodic jobs, he basically would talk to the producers and say, you know, if Millicent screwed up, I'll be there. And I can never repay that. And not that he ever had to show up and do it, but the fact that he was willing to put himself on the line for me showed other people that somebody who they feel very highly about and who is very respected and very talented believes in me. And that's the little extra oomph that I needed to help get me started. And then once I got started, it was up to me to prove that I deserved to be there.
Do you feel that you have an obligation to live your life in such a way that people are influenced by you in a positive way?
I don't know if I feel obligated, but I feel it is necessary to live my life in a positive way and set forth an example. I have 3-year-old twins. One is a girl, one is a boy. I think it's important for me to set an example for the two of them, and I live my life accordingly. As an African-American female director, there are not a lot of us. And I know that the stakes are very high. If I screw up, that means the next African-American female who comes to meet with the producers are going to say no to because it didn't work out with me. So I do feel, I guess, some sort of obligation to continue to keep the door open by doing great work.
So you just said that you feel that you have to do well for the next person.
Yes.
We're here at the 42nd Annual NAACP Luncheon, which celebrates 102 years of the organization today. Do you feel like you've kind of connected with the people that came before you that helped you get to where you are today?
Oh, absolutely. I think that, you know, I was just at a Television Academy event that was the Hall of Fame, and they honored Diane Carroll. And you think about how many doors that she opened. I can't even begin to talk about how many people opened doors that I benefited from. So hope they open doors for me, so it's my turn to open doors for others that I don't even know about.
Some people, they'll know something and they won't reach back and mentor someone. Do you believe in mentoring someone?
Absolutely.
And growing them so that they, not, because some people get jealous and they don't want to mentor people because they're afraid that person's going to take their spot.
No.
So you have no problem mentoring and helping a young person?
No, if someone did it for me, I would do it for someone else. Paris Barkley didn't have fear. I think when you're a person who is afraid to reach back and to help somebody else grow, and you're afraid that they may take your spot, that means you're just afraid and scared about your own ability and your own talent, and you don't believe in your talent. And I believe in my talent. I'm very secure in my talent and my ability, and I have no fear that there's enough space for me to bring up somebody else and give them a spot and still have room for me.
You're amazing. It was a pleasure. Thank you so much for stopping to talk to FOSDP. Blessings and favor over your life.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Thank you so much for watching FOSDP. And remember, hang on to the Lord as this world spins around. Never let the spin get you down. This has been another awesome edition of FOSDP. God bless.